You had SEBI, whose focus was on development of capital markets. I remember in 97, I was trying to negotiate a loan with the World Bank for $1 billion for development of long-term debt. After 1 year of discussion, I actually did not know who will be the owner of that fund or my key counterparty in Government of India. That is the state. You today do not have a single champion. You have voices which we hear, you have panelists which you have discussions which you have. You do not have one single champion whose life and death depends on the development of the debt market. In a way, the way this whole conference is structured is actually very beautifully done. You have said, let's issue discuss of participation, then come to development, then come to regulation. Any discussion first jumps to regulation. I think what is required here is actually a discussion on development, which I think next session will address issues to. Very clearly, regulate what if it doesn't even exist? Today, effectively, you are regulating 93% of government bond market, which is irrelevant. I don't need to really regulate and worry about it. And even there, as it was pointed out, there is no liquidity. Everybody holds it to maturity. Or you do it at the year end to sort out your balance sheet issues. I think rating, you know, the point which Mr. Dehasli very rightly pointed out, by the nature of the infrastructure development, all investments are happening in SPVs. SPVs obviously had no track record, obviously have no rating. Now, I think the only way to do then is to in fact create, yes, you do not have a substantive significant guarantee agency. To say that you should actually do entire structured debt obligations, which would at best take you to AA and things like this, will be today governed by the parent company extending those support. But I think if the government and all of us are really keen, we need to set up a sovereign rating, a sovereign guarantee agency, which actually provides entire structured debt obligations, which would at best take you to AA and things like this, will be today governed by the parent company extending those support. But I think if the government and all of us are really keen, we need to set up a sovereign rating, a sovereign guarantee agency, which actually provides whole lot of credit enhancements or risk mitigation policies. Only if you have those credit enhancement and risk mitigation at a pan-India larger corporate level will you see the whole debt market, the entire issue of ratings actually getting addressed. Now, so if I were to say very clearly yes, refinancing by ECBs will clearly at some point of time, takeout will happen. We had, you know, today we talk of IFCL, but let's not forget when IDFC was set up in 97 by Mr. Chidambaram's announcement, IDFC was supposed to provide takeout financing and basis on bonds. In fact, in the first two projects of Ahmedabad, Mehsana and Baroda Halol, IDFC did provide takeout financing as way back as 2000-2001. Today, IFCL says, yes, they are actually the precursors and the leaders, but the instrument was introduced way back 10 years ago. It did not take off. Now, I think these are the issues which you would clearly look at. So I think if you were to ask me, clear issues, we simply, with a government debt being the predominant 93%, you cannot have a significant debt market, corporate debt market actually going on. Second issue which Mr. Devasali mentioned, in fact, we had asked, Mr. Devasali and I both were together in London, and I'd actually asked the finance secretary there. I said, by giving 20,000 rupees as a limit, you're actually having nobody significant. The cost of transactions are so high. You want to direct whole lot of high net worth individuals to come into the sector. And then you say, invest, you can only invest 20,000 rupees. In fact, you ask Mr. Devasali, his cost of issue of this tax-free bond would actually be, it doesn't make sense. From equity building point of view, yes. From actual commerce point of view, no. So I think if Government of India really needs to do directional savings, you need to increase this limit to very significantly, at least to 1 lakh rupees for an individual, at the minimum. I would even say 2 lakhs and 5 lakhs rupees, and even allow corporates and others to actually subscribe to this limit. Change it. Do this for a couple of years and then withdraw it, by which the market becomes stable. You see, after all, you provide stimulus to the economy. No stimulus is a permanent solution. Stimulus is to kickstart and to change the inertia, state of inertia. It's to change, it's like an inflection point. So I think if you introduce these tax incentives for a couple of, so you actually say, I'm introducing them to encourage and to actually develop the market. And at a point of time when the market develops, I'll possibly withdraw them. Very clearly, maybe you should actually set up a JS debt market in Ministry of Finance, under Ministry of Financial Services. Create and tell SEBI, look, we would want as a target to say that 30% trades or 20% trades are on bond market. That is my agreement which I want to do with you. You know, we all talk of performance mechanism things. We all talk of KPIs. Why don't you tell the chairman SEBI? And I know it's not going to happen. Okay? But I'm still saying, unless and until we start thinking like this, look, at least 20% of the market over a 5-year period should be trading in corporate debt. And that's how I'm going to monitor your performance. If that's not happening, you have clearly failed in one key part of your responsibilities. I think we need to completely relook at the fiscal incentive structures, very clearly even relook at the fact of the directives which are given to insurance companies, PF funds. Mm-hmm. I know you want to protect the small investor, but if you create a guarantee agency, that issue of safety will be taken care of. In any case, corporate debt will not be more than 20-30% of our debt, and it could actually be given the first charge. And these are, you see, on infrastructure, there is essentially no demand risk. So the question of failure does not arise. It's a matter of, instead of Rohit Modi paying, Mr. Devasani will take over and pay for it. The demand stream, the don't think the risks of infrastructure are that high, and hence the investment guidelines for infrastructure would be completely different than what they are for other corporates. That's few of the opportunities.
Thank you. I think someone will once again communicate your passionate fear for tax exemptions to Ministry of Finance. There are some very high quality journalists sitting over here. So, and plus there are so many others, so I suppose they will communicate. We are running behind schedule, but I just want, with your permission, 5 minutes, I just want to dwell on 2 points. And I just want to understand from Vaidyanathan and all the panel members, and particularly Nilesh, please tell us whether retail participation is necessary or not necessary in the for development of the bond market. It's very important. And then the other important related issue is, you have suggested some mechanism of credit enhancement or lender comfort, RKC Act, etc. What are the hurdles? Why is it that, because I must tell you that even specialized infrastructure finance companies, which have special dispensation given by Reserve Bank of India, they also have applied for this exemption from SARFAC, and there is some reluctance to give this. I do agree that this is a great comfort, especially for those who are infrastructure-oriented companies. So the first point is retail participation a must? That's what we need to first understand. Whether we can do with institutional participation, FIIs, Indian institutional participation, or do we need vibrant retail market?
Can I make a quick point on this? I know Nilesh is much more educated and went by this. You know, a simple point today, we all keep discussing that as each company is trying to breach its own limits, one thing which will come in the way is the exposure norms, either for individual group individual entities or group companies. The only way to then breach the exposure norms will be to actually have a whole lot of retail participation, and which will then actually open up, create competition, and also breach the exposure limit norms. So that's just one additional why it should be there.
But retail participation does not really guarantee depth in the market. Retail participation, you know, if you look at, if it is in the nature of fixed deposits, I don't know whether, because as Mr. Arti said, there is a mindset issue.
Hold to maturity.
Of bringing people to this debt market. Nilesh, would you like to comment? Yeah, sure. Yes, sir.
Sir, as of today, the cost of disintermediation with retail investor is so high that unless until you are willing to pay a price for getting money out of them, which we witnessed in a couple of bond issuances where the coupon was much higher than what wholesale market was offering, it didn't take the investors' money out of their pocket. So till such time, we can develop a mechanism whereby the cost of disintermediation can come down dramatically. There's no point in developing retail bond market for wholesale borrowers. Mm.
So you are saying that the focus should be on institutional?
Focus right now on institutional market, reduce the cost of disintermediation. What we are doing on IPO in the equity side, can the same thing be done about the debt side? If we can bring down that cost of disintermediation to 0.25% or 0.5% rather than the current, you know, multiple percentages, otherwise it will not make sense. But then corporate will do charitable activity to retail investors. If we see the oversubscription in all the bond issuances, it is not because retailers are liking it, it's because they were mispriced in terms of cost.
Yeah, but at the same time, we are also talking in the context of the infrastructure sector. Because those issuances, if you talk about the State Bank of India issuance, I don't know whether that is representative for infrastructure sector. If lots of infrastructure companies have to come to the market, first of all, they have to price it well in any case. But for that particular sector, it is a case for developing the retail market.